Hello and welcome to the latest ACS travel restrictions news. This week we are coming from our operations centre and our global headquarters in the UK. For our report this week, we wanted to focus on the confusion caused by the UK government's issuing of two travel restrictions lists, one issued by the Department of Transport, the DOT, and the other, the Foreign and Commonwealth Office, the FCO. On the 3rd of July, the DOT issued a list of 76 countries and territories that from the 10th of July do not require 14 days quarantine when arriving into England. However, on the 4th of July, the FCO issued another list of just 67 countries and territories that are now exempt from the FCO advice for non-essential travel. So why are there two different lists? Well, there is actually a straightforward answer to this question, and I'll try to explain. The DOT list of 76 countries and territories is a list of places that from the 10th of July, you will no longer require 14 days home quarantine after arriving into England. However, if you have visited a country not on the list in the previous 14 days, you will still need to quarantine for the difference in days. For example, if you travel from Portugal and spend 4 days in Spain and then travel on to England, you will only require 10 days quarantine when you arrive into England. If you are travelling from a listed country but transiting through a non-listed country, as long as no one disembarks or embarks the aircraft, no quarantine is required when arriving into England. Otherwise, 14 days quarantine is required. However, this list is not a list of countries that necessarily have a reciprocal agreement with arrivals into their country. For example, Greece is on this list. However, Greece will only accept arrivals from England after the 15th of July. Hong Kong and Australia are also on this list, however they have strict entry restrictions, with quarantine being just one of them. Another example, Singapore is not on the list, so if you fly from Australia to England via Singapore and you disembark or others embark, you will require 14 days quarantine on arrival into England. So why is there an FCO list? Well, this is purely a list of countries that the FCO is now allowing non-essential travel to. This is after assessing the risk of travelling to those destinations. And whilst offering travellers reassurance, this change is also very important for any insurance coverage. There are 13 countries on the FCO list not listed on the DOT list, and there are 22 countries on the DOT list not listed on the FCO list. Although this is a step towards the new normal, it is very clear that there are misconceptions surrounding these changes. Many restrictions still apply, and most importantly, they can change without warning. So it's very important to do your due diligence when looking to make plans this summer. In summary, if you are looking to travel from England without the need to quarantine at your destination or return to England and be covered by the FCO's advice for non-essential travel, we have identified a list of 31 countries that it is possible to visit this summer. 23 of those are in Europe. A list of these countries can be found on our travel restrictions website. If you can travel, please stay safe, and we will continue to keep you updated with the very latest global travel restrictions news next week.